The heart is a muscle working night and day to circulate blood. You are generally unaware of your heart's hard work unless you feel a fluttering in the left side of your chest, a possible symptom of atrial fibrillation. Dr. Hetal Bhakta of Desert Regional Medical Center describes the symptoms and treatments commonly used to treat this condition.
Atrial fibrillation is a problem which is mainly of the electrical system of the heart. So when you look at the heart itself, it's made up of a couple of different things, not unlike the homes that we live in. So heart has four chambers, two on the top that are called atria and two on the bottom that are called ventricles. The chambers are no different than the rooms of our homes. And the plumbing and the wiring runs through the walls of those rooms. Now, the electrical system of the heart is responsible for coordinating heart's activity. And the way heart's activity is coordinated is the top chambers squeeze and fill the bottom chambers, and then the bottom chambers squeeze and pump the blood to the body or to the lungs. So the top chambers get their signal from the brain. So if you're sitting down, it'll say, stay at rest. If you're moving about, it'll say, go faster. Now, that's normal way the heart goes up and down. When you go into atrial fibrillation, the brain no longer has any control over the speed or the rate of the heart. There's actually short circuits inside the wiring system that causes the rate to speed up very dramatically. And that's how you get AFib.
Dr. Bhakta explains how atrial fibrillation affects your heart.
If you imagine when we are going through our life, we get problems like high blood pressure and diabetes and sleep apnea and things like that, which puts stress on the heart. That stress is not unlike you putting pressure on the rooms inside. It's going to cause the walls to crack. And when that happens, the wiring system in there tends to crack, and that tends to expose the wires and break the wires. And that's what gives you the short circuit, which triggers the atrial fibrillation. It does not really hurt. And a lot of people who have atrial fibrillation don't even feel that they have atrial fibrillation. Why? Because the top chambers of the heart, you don't feel them beating. You only feel the bottom chambers, which are the pumps of your heartbeat. So when you go into atrial fibrillation, the top chambers are beating at around 400 to 500 times a minute. But you're not going to feel your heart racing 400 to 500 times a minute, because if it were doing that, it would just twitch, so nothing would move. In response, the bottom chambers are beating around 150, 180 times per minute, and that's the sensation that you feel. So a lot of people might have AFib, but they won't have the fast ventricular response, and they won't feel that they have atrial fibrillation. It is very dangerous, because the atrial fibrillation, the two main problems that occur with it. So atria, which are the top chambers, when they fibrillate, they just twitch, meaning they're not squeezing and filling the ventricles properly. So if they don't squeeze the blood into the ventricles and fill the ventricles or the pumps properly, you're not going to be able to pump that blood out if it was never there. So because less blood is moving in your body, people tend to feel tired, fatigued, short of breath easily. The other more serious problem that atrial fibrillation presents is when the heart is just twitching on the top, blood tends to stagnate into the nooks and crannies of the heart. And when it stagnates, it develops little blood clots. If the blood clot dislodges and goes up into the brain, it gives you a stroke. If it ends up into your heart arteries, then it'll give you a heart attack, so on and so forth.
Dr. Bhakta talks about the treatment for atrial fibrillation.
So there are different ways you can treat atrial fibrillation. You can treat it by giving medications. A lot of times these medications are also toxic and they cause other problems or other arrhythmias to come by. So another way to treat it is to do a procedure that we call ablation, where we take wires inside the heart and we find these abnormal circuits that are in the heart, and then we burn those circuits out. Once we burn those circuits out, the normal wires take over and they start working properly.